I will praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will tell of your name to my King. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Calling to mind our sins, we ask the Lord for pardon and strength. You were sent to go to try to heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father, who intercedes for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which, through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we earnestly beseech your mercy, Lord, that while we celebrate the faith we may possess in an ending love, for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not whoever lives in truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I bet, as you heard the Gospel passage read, that you were praying along in your heart to the first verse in today's Gospel. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. John 3:16 is the most famous Gospel passage in the world, and has been called the Gospel in a nutshell. It has gained force in popular culture because there are sports heroes that have written John 3:16 on their jerseys, and very often to be seen at different sporting events. There'll be people dressed up and holding a sign that says John 3:16. But it serves as a reminder to us, especially in the difficulty in which we find ourselves, when we might feel challenged or alone, or we may feel overwhelming sadness come over us, that in the inability to see our friends, and to be with other people, or to be with our family members, we might feel left behind. But let us recall the power and the beauty of today's Gospel, and the reminder that God so loved the world. And we are part of that. We're part of the world. God loved each one of us, that he gave his only begotten Son. And that is why Christians revel in the cross. That's why so much of a part of our Catholic faith means that we have the crucifix displayed in our churches, in our homes, and on our persons. That those who believe in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. That is the reason for our Easter faith and our hope and knowledge of the resurrection. And so, may we know that we are not alone, that we are loved by God, and that we are part of a plan. And even in the darkness and difficulty of this pandemic, we are part of a greater plan of love for us. We lift up our prayers today, all of those who are sick with the virus. We recall their nurses and doctors, all the caregivers, families, and friends who are affected. We pray for those who keep the supply chains running, and we pray for all of those who feel alone and unloved, for all the isolated customers, for all of those who are economically affected by furloughs and layoffs, that we may soon return to normality and to happiness. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover is your sacrifice. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is our sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the ending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are the holy Lord, the fount of all holiness, and holy therefore these gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon the life of these all, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer the Lord the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope Wilton, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, know with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously. By the help of your mercy, amen. not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gracious grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold it takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I have chosen you from the world, says the Lord, and have appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Gracious